Okay, let's get into it. Welcome to the Deep Dive.
Glad to be here.
Today, we're focusing on a pretty specific topic,
Yeah.
giving an intramuscular injection, an IM shot.
That's right. And we're grounding this discussion in information from Medline Plus. It's a service of the National Library of Medicine, so a reliable source.
Exactly. And our mission today isn't to teach how to do it per se, but really to unpack what this specific source says about it. Why IM injections are used, what you need.
The really crucial stuff, like where to give them safely, how the source says to do it step by step, and also, importantly, the precautions and warning signs.
Yeah, because understanding this process, maybe for yourself or someone you care for, it relies on clear info. So this deep dive is all about exploring the guidance from this Medline Plus material.
So let's start with the basics, according to the source. What even is an IM injection?
Right. Fundamentally, it's a shot of medicine that goes directly into a muscle. Pretty straightforward definition.
And the source stresses why it says for certain medicines, this is the only way they'll work properly. It doesn't go into, the dub science of it.
No, it keeps it practical.
But the core message is clear. Muscle delivery is essential for these specific drugs.
Got it. The muscle's the target. So what does Medline Plus say you need to have ready? What are the supplies?
Okay, the list is specific. You need one alcohol wipe, one sterile 2x2 gauze pad, a new needle and syringe. And it specifically points out the needle needs to be long enough to actually reach the muscle tissue.
That detail about length seems important, suggests depth matters a lot.
Definitely. And finally, a cotton ball for afterwards.
Okay, alcohol wipe, gauze, new needle, and syringe of the right length, cotton ball,
Yeah.
seems clear. But then the source really spends time on where to give the shot. It seems like site selection is a major
Oh,
focus.
absolutely critical, according to this guide. The whole goal they lay out is getting the medicine into the muscle.
While missing the tricky bits.
Exactly. While
Yeah.
actively avoiding nerves or blood vessels. And interestingly, before detailing the sites, the source gives this piece of advice. Show your healthcare provider how you plan to find the spot.
Ah, so get it checked first.
Yeah, basically confirm you've understood the location correctly for safety. That really underscores how important finding the right landmark is.
That makes a lot of sense. It's not just about reading instructions. Okay, so the source describes four main spots. I'll walk through them. First up, the thigh.
Right, the thigh. The source presents this as a good option, especially if you're giving the injection to yourself or for young children, specifically under 3 years old.
Okay, and how do you find the spot there?
You picture the thigh kind of divided into three equal parts, like horizontal bands, top, middle, bottom. The injection goes right into that middle part. It's described as relatively easy to locate.
Middle third of the thigh.
Yeah.
Got it. What about the hip? The source says this one's for adults and children older than 7 months. Sounds a bit more complex to find.
It is a bit more involved, yeah. For the hip, the person needs to be lying on their side.
Okay.
Then you place the heel of your hand, where the thigh bone meets the buttocks. Your thumb points towards the groin, fingers towards the head.
Right, I'm picturing that.
Then you spread your index finger away from your other fingers, forming a V shape. The source says you might feel a bone edge there. The injection goes right in the middle of that V, between your index and middle finger.
Huh. That V-shape method, using the bones as guides, very
It
specific.
really is clearly designed to isolate that muscle safely.
Okay, next is the upper arm muscle, the deltoid.
Yes, the upper arm. But there's a condition here. The source says you can use it if the muscle is well developed enough, if you can feel it easily.
Ah, so not for everyone.
Right. It explicitly warns against it if the person is very thin or the muscle feels small. To find it, you uncover the arm. Think of an upside-down triangle on the outer part of the arm. The base of that triangle is the bone across the top of the upper arm, the acromion.
There.
The point of the triangle is sort of down toward the armpit level.
Got it.
The injection spot is in the center of that triangle, about 1 to 2 inches. That's like 2.5 to 5 centimeters below that top bone.
So checking the muscle mass first is key for the arm. All right, finally, the buttocks. And there's a big warning here for little kids.
A very strong warning. The source is emphatic. Do not use the buttocks for a child under 3. The reason given is they just don't have enough muscle there yet.
Okay, that's crucial. And even for adults, it sounds like you need to be careful.
Extremely careful. Lots of important nerves, like the sciatic nerve and blood vessels, are in that area. So precision is vital. You uncover one buttock. Imagine drawing a line from the top of the crack between the buttocks over towards the side of the hip, and another line kind of upwards from the bottom of the buttock towards the hip bone. This creates sort of a four-quadrant box on the buttock.
Okay, visualizing a cross.
Exactly. The injection goes in the upper outer quadrant of that box, and specifically below the curved part of the hip bone you can feel there.
Wow. Those site descriptions are incredibly detailed. Relies a lot on feeling for bones and visualizing lines. That advice about showing your provider first makes even more sense now.
It really does. Understanding it intellectually is one thing. Reliably finding it on a person, that's another. Practice and confirmation seem essential based on this source.
Okay, so we know where potentially. Now, how does the source say to actually give the injection? What are the steps?
Right, breaks it down into 10 clear steps. Step one, double check the medicine. Make sure it's the right medicine, right amount in the syringe. Basic safety.
Can't skip that. Then hygiene.
Yep. Step two, wash your hands really well. Soap, water, dry thoroughly. Step three, carefully find that chosen injection spot again.
Right.
Step four, clean the skin right there with an alcohol wipe. Let it air dry completely. Don't blow on it or wave it.
Okay. And step five.
Take the cap off the needle. Carefully.
All right. Prep is done. Now the actual injection part.
Step six, seven, and eight. Step six, gently hold the muscle around the spot. Thumb and index finger, kind of bunch it up slightly.
Okay.
Step seven, the insertion. It says use a quick, firm thrust. Put the needle straight in, like a dart, at a 90-degree angle to the skin.
Straight in, 90 degrees. Got it.
That angle is key to hit the muscle. Step eight, push the plunger smoothly to inject the medicine.
Okay. Quick in, inject, then what?
Step nine, pull the needle straight back out, same angle it went in.
Right.
And step 10, press on the spot with that cotton ball. Hold it there for a moment.
Okay. And the source mentioned something about multiple injections.
Yes. Important point. If more than one shot is needed over time, do not keep using the exact same spot. You need to rotate sites. Use the other side of the body or a different approved site altogether.
Makes sense. Let the tissue recover. So, injection done. But what about the used needle and syringe? Disposal is a big deal.
Huge deal. And the source is very direct here. First rule. Do not try to put the cap back on the needle. Recapping is a major cause of needle stick injuries.
Okay, no recapping. What do you do then?
Put the used syringe and needle straight into a sharps container immediately.
And why is that so critical?
Because, as the source states plainly, putting loose needles or syringes in the regular trash is dangerous. Someone could get stuck.
Right, protecting sanitation workers or anyone handling the trash. What if you don't have an official sharps container?
The source offers practical advice. You can use a sturdy container you might have at home, like a plastic milk jug or maybe a coffee can with a secure lid.
Oh, okay.
But it has to be strong enough that needles can't poke through the sides, and the opening needs to fit the syringe but be securable.
And then what do you do with the full jug or can?
Crucially, the source says to ask your healthcare provider or pharmacist how to properly get rid of that container safely. Disposal options vary by location.
Good point. It's not just about the container, but its final destination. Okay, finally, the source covers when to worry, when to seek help after an injection. It lists some urgent emergency signs.
Yes, this is vital information. Call 911 or your local emergency number right away if the person experiences any of these. Gets a sudden rash. Feels extremely itchy all over.
Okay.
Has trouble breathing, feels short of breath, or notices swelling, especially around the mouth, lips, or face.
Those sound like serious allergic reactions.
Exactly. Anaphylaxis, potentially.
Yeah.
Needs immediate medical intervention.
Definitely. Are there other things, maybe less urgent, where you should still contact your provider?
Yes, the source lists a few scenarios for that. First, kind of circling back, if you just have questions or doubts about how to give the injection, better to ask than guess.
Makes sense. Call before you proceed if unsure. What else?
Second, if the person develops a fever or generally feels sick after the injection, could be an infection or something else.
Right, we're checking out.
And third, if there's a lump or maybe significant bruising or swelling at the injection site that just doesn't go away after a few days, could indicate a local issue.
So different levels of concern, different actions required. That's clear guidance.
It really covers the key points from this Medline Plus source. The why, the what, the where, the how, the disposal, and the red flags.
Yeah, we've definitely unpacked a lot of detail there. It really highlights the level of precision and care needed for what might seem like a simple procedure.
It does. Following reliable, detailed guidance like this is clearly paramount.
So wrapping up this deep dive into the Medline Plus guide on IM injections, We've covered the reasons, the supplies, those very specific site locations, the step-by-step process, safe disposal, and the crucial warning signs. It really shows the depth of information available from sources like Medline Plus.
Absolutely. A lot packed into that guidance.
And it makes me think, considering all those intricate steps, especially finding the right anatomical spot, and how the source repeatedly emphasizes showing your provider first and contacting them with questions, what is that constant reinforcement of needing professional guidance, even with a detailed guide in hand, really tell us about the complexities and potential risks involved in doing this in the real world? Something definitely worth reflecting on if this procedure is relevant to you.